I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making creamy cauliflower soup. Now you may change it to creamy broccoli soup if you prefer broccoli to cauliflower, but I have not done a whole lot with cauliflower and I've done plenty with broccoli in Betty's Kitchen. So here we have a 3-quart saucepan and I have put 2 cups of water in there. So I'm taking this to the stove and we'll turn that on about medium and bring that to a boil. And while that's coming to a boil, I will tell you about my cauliflower. This was a small head of cauliflower and I just washed it, removed the outer leaves, cut out the core, and any brown spots that I might have seen, I removed, although there were hardly any at all. This was very fresh. And then I just tore it into florets. So any size that you want, it separates very easily. Those are the florets. So this is one small head. You can use more if you like. I also have a 3/4 cup of chopped celery that I'll be using, and I have 3/4 cup of chopped onions. In addition, I'm going to be adding in 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. So when this comes to a boil, which it's not there yet, I'll put those things in and then we'll continue. Our vegetables are done and they just came off the stove, and you'll notice that I covered them with a lid, brought them to a boil again, and then I let them boil for 10 minutes. That should be perfect, but you'll probably want to take a fork and see if they're tender. See, that goes in very easily. It's really nice. And the thing, if you check the cauliflower, if it's okay, then the rest of it will definitely be okay. We're going to blend this. So I have a blender sitting right here ready to go. And I think I'll start by using a ladle so that I won't be splashing some of this liquid. And we'll just dip part of this in to the point where maybe we can pour the rest. Now I'm going to put the lid on. You'll notice that I left it undrained. You want all that good juice because it's going to have flavor in it. And then put the lid on your blender. And then I think I'm just going to pulse and watch it until it looks like it's fairly uniform in consistency. I'm going to take a peek. And that looks perfect. It's got a few lumps here and there, but you don't want everything to be just liquid food just because it's soup. So I'm going to let this sit for a minute while I prepare some other ingredients to go in it. So I'll be back to do that preparation. I'm starting with a 3-quart saucepan, and I have put 2 tablespoons of butter into the saucepan and I've melted it. To that I'm adding 2 tablespoons of flour. And then stirring that around. And this is forming a roux, but we need to go to the stove and cook that. So we'll cook until it's nice and bubbly. Stirring constantly. Roux is nice and bubbly, so I'm going to add 2½ cups of water. Now I'm going to bring that to a boil over medium heat, and then I will boil this for 1 minute before I continue the recipe. This has been bubbling for 1 minute. So we're ready to come back over here and add some ingredients. I have 1 tablespoon of chicken bouillon. You can get that in a little jar in granule form. We'll stir that in. We're adding 3/4 teaspoon salt. We're adding 1/8 teaspoon ground black pepper. And then just a pinch of nutmeg. And stir. Some nice flavors to flavor up our cauliflower. And the next thing we're going to do is put our cauliflower in. So it looks like the 3-quart saucepan is going to be fine to hold our blended cauliflower. Just watch out for it splashing a little. And then stir. And then take this back to the stove and heat it up. And we will have one more ingredient when this is heated. Our mixture has been boiling for 1 minute. It's nice and bubbly on the top. So we're going to add our last ingredient. Our last ingredient is heavy cream, or you could use a lighter version of it if you like. It's 1/2 cup, so I'm going to put that in, stir it around quickly. And then I'd like for the soup to come up to heat so that it's at the boiling point, but I don't want it to boil. So I'll watch it and I'll be stirring continuously, and we just want it heated is all. My lunch is ready and I have creamy cauliflower soup. You can see what it came out like. Here's the whole amount minus what I put in my bowl. So you can see how much it makes. I'd say it makes really 4 good servings for lunch. Or if it's on the side, you could serve more. But here we have the cauliflower soup, and I have chosen a pretzel roll to go with it. I think some kind of bread is nice, or you could use crackers if you prefer. And then some veggies. I've picked some things that complement the flavors of the soup. There was celery in the soup. Obviously there was cauliflower in the soup, and there was onion, not green onion, but I thought that was prettier as a garnish or a side plate. And then if you would like to have just a tiny amount of extra protein in there, because we have, I guess, just a slight amount in that cream. The rest of it was rather watery and full of vegetables, so it's quite healthy. But here is some grated Romano cheese. You might want to try something like that, or a different kind of cheese. I'm going to take a taste. Now, this has not been here very long, so I'm sure it's piping hot. But that hasn't stopped me before, so let me just try it. That is delicious. You wouldn't believe what all of those additions at the end, what a difference it has made in just a plain cauliflower flavor. It's you almost don't recognize it as having cauliflower. It's all those other flavors blended together that make it taste so good. And I think it will be great if you want to put some cheese on it, or eat it with a roll, or with crackers. Enjoy.